Human society was created because of food. It was easier to make food together. When I was 12, I went on a camping trip with some vegetarians. Somehow I made that connection. I came home and I announced that I was no longer eating meat. A few months later, my mother just said, "You know what? I'm not preparing a vegetarian meal for you. You're on your own, you cook." I started cooking when I was probably 12 and a half. My mission has partly been for a long time to make really wonderful food accessible to all, to take the mystery out of it, to take the fear factor out of it. A lot of people feel, well, plant-based is about, you know, I want to be healthy. And I think that's great. It gets a door open, but at some point, it's not just about personal health. If we just think about our personal health, we don't think beyond ourselves. It doesn't matter if we've got washboard abs. It doesn't matter if you can be an ultra-marathoner on a plant-based diet if the planet is dying, if all the other animals on the planet, if the species are being wiped out because of animal agriculture. We have to think beyond ourselves. We have to think about the lives of all living beings on this planet. We have to think about the living planet itself. We have to think about whether or not we can feed 10 billion people. We have to think about the amount of land that's allocated to animal agriculture and what that's doing in terms of food equity for people across the globe. What about the person in India or Africa or somewhere else in a food desert right here in the United States that doesn't have access to healthy, sustainable, organic foods? We have to start thinking about them. Let's start thinking beyond ourselves, and we have to remember that the world is made up of individuals. So the faster that individuals can make that change, just having that knowledge is a key to your own personal happiness, because you can wake up every day feeling empowered that I am doing something to help change the course of the planet.